There's an easy pathway to discover more high-paying customers, and the way to do it is through using data. Everybody knows that data is the heart of every business's success. The trouble is, when there's so much of it, it can sometimes be a challenge to understand where to put your attention. Introducing ConvertKit's brand new feature, Insights, an advanced analytics dashboard we built in collaboration with Segmetrics that is available to all Creator Pro users. It's the easiest way to find key insights that will guide you into making all the best decisions with your emails to help your business succeed. So in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how you can use insights to stop wasting your time, start focusing on relevant areas of your marketing, and land even more high-paying customers. And you might be thinking, having all of that data is good and well, but making sense of what you're looking for is like trying to find a needle in a haystack, but you're not exactly sure what needle you're looking for and which stack that needle is actually in. It's there somewhere, you just don't know where to look. That's why Insights has been broken up into four separate dashboards, which helps simplify the data so it's easier to make sense of. The dashboards have been designed to cut out the raw data and offer you quick answers without having to do any additional digging. So to start making sense of this data, you first have to understand exactly what you're looking for. And that first thing is understanding how people are actually finding you. The acquisition dashboard will help you find the answers to the following questions. Who's visiting your site? Which of those visitors actually subscribe? What are the specific pages bringing those new subscribers through the door? And what are each of those subscribers or pages actually worth? All you have to do is look at the individual widget that you're interested in and then hover your mouse over it, or in some cases, you actually click on some of the data and it'll give you exactly what you need to know. What's great is in all of these dashboards, you can choose the time that you want to see. So maybe you'd like to check out activity within the last 30 days. All you have to do is click on the timeline bar and change it to the time range that you're interested in exploring. For example, the visitors widget allows you to see how many people have visited your website within the given time. There's a blue one that shows the current time period, in this case, the previous 30 days, and then the gray one that displays the last time period, so the 30 days before that. So that way you can see both of them and then compare them to each other. From looking at the acquisitions dashboard, you can instantly be able to find out how many visitors have chosen to sign up and the average dollar value of one of your subscribers within a given time period. This dollar value is based on how much money you've earned on average from your subscribers. Knowing that lets you know how much you can spend on marketing to acquire new leads. You wouldn't want to spend more on a subscriber than what they are actually worth. This gives you that information without having to do any additional calculations. You can also go into further detail with other widgets displaying exactly which campaigns, pages, and channels are performing the best. But knowing this is made even more powerful when you look at the engagement dashboard. And so it's important to know what's bringing your subscribers in, but it's even more important to know how people are engaging with your emails once they have arrived. Without knowing this, you're gonna end up wasting precious spots on your list and sending emails to people who never read them. So in order to save yourself from talking to a brick wall of subscribers who aren't even listening and paying for it, this is where the engagement dashboard comes in. Using this, you'll be able to find out the answers to questions such as how many people are clicking on your emails, how long do they stay engaged, how much money are different segments of your list worth, and what does your customer journey actually look like. Just like the acquisitions dashboard, the engagement dashboard is split up into different widgets that will allow you to find key pieces of information. At a glance, you can quickly see the amount of subscribers who have clicked on at least one email within your specified time period. By looking at that engagement percentage, you'll also get a pretty good idea of how many of your subscribers are actually interested in opening your emails. But wait, there's more. The engagement by segment widget reveals how long your subscribers stay engaged. By understanding how many months pass before your subscribers stop clicking on your emails, you'll be able to figure out what's not working and then alter your strategy until you continue to keep them engaged. You can break this down even further in the performance breakdown widget, which allows you to compare the number of signups or subscribers customers, and total revenue by different segments of your list. But of course, engagement means nothing if they don't choose to buy anything, which is why you're gonna need to understand how to use the sales dashboard. This is where things get pretty exciting, because when you know where your best potential customers are coming from, you'll understand how to focus your efforts and obtain the right results, which is more of those really high value customers. There's a rule applied by Italian economist Vilfredo Pareto. It's called the 80-20 rule. And you can use this idea to find more success in your marketing. So Pareto observed that 80% of the consequences come from 20% of the causes. So for you, that means 80% of the results that you receive come from 20% of the effort that you're putting in. So if you can get a grasp of this data, you'll know exactly what that 20% of effort is, which will save you time and optimize your results. This sales dashboard will help you understand the answer to questions like, what's the value of an average order and customer? What are your top products? And what channels, pages, and segments earn you the most money. This sales dashboard works only with native ConvertKit products that you're selling inside of ConvertKit Commerce. So if you haven't brought your digital products in yet, now is the time to do it. And remember that we have one of the lowest transaction fees out there. The sales widget reveals how many sales you've made based on the timeline you've set, while the revenue widget reveals how much revenue these sales have made you in total. But the real power comes from customer value. This widget shows you for the given time window how much money each customer is worth on average. This will help you predict how much money you can expect to earn from new customers. The value does not stop there though, because with the top products tab, you will be able to figure out which of your products are selling the best. And the revenue by source widget reveals a pie chart that will show you where all of your revenue is coming from. By comparing the revenue for each of your channels, you'll get an idea of what's working well so you can double down on the channels that are doing well and then make changes to the ones that aren't. But there's one last critical piece of information you need before you can see the complete picture. And this one truly does sweeten the deal. It is the velocity dashboard. It shows you how quickly people subscribe to your newsletter. This is going to help you evaluate how effective your lead generation strategies are. For example, let's say the time that it takes from when someone first lands on your site to when they actually sign up for your newsletter is 14 days. That's an indication that the copy on your page is not compelling enough for them to sign up sooner. So you have to make some changes and then maybe wait a couple weeks and then compare the last 2 weeks when you had this change in place to the previous 2 weeks before you made that change to see if there was an improvement. This dashboard also reveals how quickly people buy, which is great because it allows you to gauge the impact of your email campaigns on your sales. But most importantly, the more time that Insights is gathering this data for you, the more valuable it's gonna be, because by tracking the growth and value of different segments over time, you can identify and nurture your most profitable customer groups. But the power of the new Insights tool doesn't stop there. And if you want an even deeper dive, don't forget to check out this playlist right here, where the team from Segmetrics dives deeper into each one of these dashboards to help you start finding more of those high-paying customers. We'll see you over there.